Santa Sue. I'm Miho Asada.
I'm Sarah Rodriguez, and this is KSSH News at Noon. You look a little stressed, Miho.
Yeah, I have a huge paper due tomorrow. I wish someone else could do it for me.
You know, Miho, copying essays and papers from the internet is a thing of the past.
Tell me more.
It's called Turnitin.com, software that searches more than 17 billion web pages in 126 countries for groupings of words, phrasing, and similar verbiage.
I've heard of that. You turn in your papers online. Colleges use it.
And we're probably next. Watch this.
Many of the seniors this year are going to college, and many of them are going to be using Turnitin.com. Let's find out more.
Turnitin.com is a web-based program where students submit their own work, and the program then uses a web crawler to search different websites, online texts, even those buy an essay cheat sites that you use, and other student papers that have been submitted to check for plagiarism and copied work.
Turnitin.com, I think, is unique in the way that it cross-references, you know, all the papers that are out there.
I think it keeps students academically honest. And the neat thing about Turnitin.com is that there's a database and it builds each time someone submits something, so it's near impossible to plagiarize anything. So I give it two thumbs up.
Here at Santa Susana High School, we use Turnitin.com for term papers, DBQs in history or any other sort of history writing that would be done. It could be used for lab reports and in any subject, but we use it more as a teaching tool rather than as a gotcha. In other words, a student would submit their paper, be able to see their results, and if there is in fact any plagiarism, and fix that problem before submitting a final draft to their teacher.
I personally found it as a good tool for me because I saw just how much I'd actually copied from other people, and it allowed me to rewrite my works better, and so it was more like my own.
Like the English department in history, we also do a lot of essay writing. And though I've never used Turnitin.com, I did a little bit of research, and the one thing I really liked about it is that they had sophisticated feedback tools. So that could actually save me a lot of time. I could maybe give more essays because it would take me less time per essay to grade.
There are over 126 countries where Turnitin.com is used, and between them all about 10,000 universities, colleges, high schools, etc. So many of the major universities and colleges right here in California and the United States already use Turnitin.com. It's something they're going to need to get to know, need to use, and very likely will be assigned to use when they get to college.
Pure wizardry.
It's time to dance.
Almost.
Dancers, crank it up a level, or get out.
Tea time with old Willie. Here to talk about his play for the day, William Shakespeare.
Oh, hello. Welcome to another episode of Story Time with Old Willie. I'm William Shakespeare. Today we'll present to you a small clip of one of my famous plays, A Midsummer Night's Dream. Take a look.
None of noble sort would so offend aversion and extort a poor soul's patience just to make you sport.
Simply marvelous. Well, that's all the time we have for now. Come see the show March 2nd to 3rd in the PAC. Oh, thank you. Marvelous.
We know about movies from Golden Reviews, but what about books?
A book reviewer? Now, who could do that?
Meyer spoke with us about The Inheritance Cycle by Christopher Paolini, the story of a boy who discovers the egg of a dragon named Sephira and the obstacles they encounter together.
Why do you think this is a good book for students in high school to read?
Well, it seems to me that that seems to be the trend these days with the Twilight series, the Harry Potter series, that the kids like to have this kind of escapist type of literature. It's a way to kind of escape reality for a while. But yet, when you read Aragon, there's a lot in there that kind of you can relate to as a teenager.
I love the Inheritance Cycle because there's so much adventure and magic packed inside, and it's a fun way to escape from reality.
What is your favorite thing in the book?
Well, I have a really unique favorite thing. It's because Saphira is female. Somehow this author, Christopher Paolini, at a very young age that he wrote Aragon, he seemed to understand the dynamics between male and female, and a lot of times how females can be somewhat exasperated with maybe the male mind, if you will. There are several scenes where I really laughed and smiled because I could almost imagine Saphira's eyes rolled to the back of her dragon head at her frustrations, if you will, at Aragon's decisions, and she has to kind of bail them out sometimes.
If you like to read fantasy, you'll love Aragon by Christopher Paolini, and this is a great start to the rest of the series.
But yet there's something to be said about seeing the glory of Saphira as she flies and the dialogue, because we are a visual age and there's nothing wrong with that. I would just recommend not seeing the movie first or instead of reading the book.
So there you have it. If you need EBS points, the first book alone is 32. So get reading, Santa Sue. Back to you in the studio.
Here's an update from Law Academy.
Roger Ebert here at school.
Let's go to Emma Ingram for this preview.
Hello, Santa Sue, and welcome to Golden Reviews Oscars edition. I'm Emma Ingram, and today we'll be reviewing all 9 films that have been nominated for Best Picture. I know, it's a lot. Let's go!
I thought it was a really moving story, and I'm reading the book, trying to get through it, and I'm really liking that as well.
The performances and the subject matter elevate the movie kind of more than the actual movie making itself.
The reason I love the artist so much is because it was so true to classic old Hollywood cinema.
A loving tribute to classic silent film Hollywood. It's a lot of fun, it's really well paced, it's a really great movie. War Horse, it's a great movie for young people. I think it does a great job of blending war and the love of animals.
I thought the use of 3D was outstanding. I think it really drew me into the film itself.
Moving tribute to the origin of movie making, it is incredible. Everyone should go see it. Probably, I think, the weakest of the Best Picture nominees. Moneyball, best Brad Pitt performance I've ever seen. It's going to be a close, tight race between George Clooney and Brad Pitt. It is epic filmmaking, changes the medium. I just think it's a little too weird for the Academy, and I don't think it'll win. It's an honor that it's just nominated. Really moving movie. Stuck with me for a while. One of my favorites of the year.
Midnight in Paris is probably my favorite movie of the year. I thought the writing was genius, and I loved Owen Wilson's character's whole mental journey.
Woody Allen is top form, really smart, a great love story to Paris and the 20s.
Now back to you in the studio.
Here's an update on another alumnus.
Nick Pappas, class of 2000, whose 10-minute play showed at the Kennedy Center in Washington, D.C. last year, just won another festival.
This time it's the Actors Theater of Louisville, and it comes with a $5,000 prize. Keep up the good work, alumni.
And that's most certainly the way it is.
February 23rd, 2012. Have a great day, Santa Sue.